Men have standards too. Men are permitted to have standards as well. Regarding women and dating, there is constant discussion about the need for women to develop standards. And in some instances, it is justified. Welcome to One Male and hello everyone. Make sure to stay tuned in and kindly hit the like button and subscribe to see more videos like this. They say I'm an overly demanding sociopath, so I'll give you a short and checklist version. It would not be very ethical to say that most have not used this list to help them persuade themselves that the vast majority of women do not deserve their time or effort. This may come across as arrogant, but men own their own homes, car, and career. Thus, we can be in a position to be vain. This is a condensed version of that list. She is as pretty as it gets, and her body is to die for. But she's not just beautiful because of how she looks. She does more for me than make me look good. She brings more to my life than her looks. I have more intimate relations when I'm single, so I want her to have distinguishing characteristics that complement mine. Second, does she have her own space, car, and hobbies outside my company? Is she aware I will not sacrifice my goals and aspirations for her? To please her, I will not give up something stupid I enjoy or for financial gain. There are two types of women. Those who want to be with a man willing to sacrifice his ambitions to make them happy, and those who want a man who will sacrifice his ambitions and goals for them. If you belong to the latter group, your happiness will likely not last long. When you're in a relationship with someone like that, you'll be constantly frustrated because they won't do the things that make them happy, and there's nothing wrong with that. What matters is what makes you happy, not what makes her happy. And if she does not share your goals, it is time to part ways. Fourthly, she devalues me. She will always want to be in control and refuse to give me any. She will always want to be in charge and refuse to give me authority. She will always want to be in control and refuse to provide him with any input. She will always desire the ability to make all decisions and refuse to delegate any to me. Since I've begun using this list, not a single woman has satisfied my requirements. By avoiding these women, I've managed to dodge many horrifying situations. Let me know how you would tune it or if you believe it to be foolish and unnecessary. Yes, my hands are improving because I'm constantly massaging my palms, but not how you think. However, I'd like to move on to the topic at hand, which is whether or not she brings anything to the table other than her breasts. There is a double standard because women require a man to have a job, but he is the wrong man if he insists she has more than $1,000 saved. Double standards. I frequently discuss this with my friends. One of them has over $1 million and is debt-free, and my friends and I all discuss how we've paid off our automobiles with significant savings. In some instances, women have said to one of my friends, "Well, that's not the latest model of a BMW." One woman has had the audacity to criticize him even though she does not own a vehicle herself. I believe that your list is essentially useless in regards to a makeup-covered credit card debt, with no assets and student loan debt for a useless marketing degree. If she has a retirement fund, it is typically tied to her employer and not her choice. If people were forced to live within their means, you might also be responsible for caring for their neglected pets. As she is typically homeless, she typically only brings you meat curtains and her reproduction. I would make no changes to your list. On dates, my friend learns that many women have no assets, whereas he has over $500,000 in the bank. Therefore, He inquires about what they bring to the table. One woman promised to oversee his finances and construct a home for him. He states that he already has a roommate and does not want a new one to force him to live in his garage or basement. They desire what you dangle in front of them like a carrot and believe you will fall in love with them and give it to them. You mention in your questions to me that you've been labeled a sociopath by friends you've told about your dating guidelines. When I was younger, I didn't realize that having standards as a man is now considered sociopathic. It was only when I got older and started seeing the world from a different perspective that I realized how many people have been taught to think that being manly means being willing to sacrifice for the team. If you are a man with high standards, you're probably called too demanding, told to find courage, or to sacrifice for your team. You may also be told that you're just another misogynist who dislikes all women, even though women can have these traits. But what if a woman has high standards? You might hear men and women call her too demanding or tell her to man up. You might also hear women say that she's just another misogynist who dislikes all women, even though she can have these traits. Homes are extremely expensive, averaging $1 million for an ordinary detached house. But what's funny is that this guy I know went on a date with a secretary who said she wanted to get married in a few years and live on her own home. He asked her how she planned to accomplish it. They will use the family car and other assets as cockroach bait and trap a woman for part-time sex in their homes as if it were a roach motel. Women believe that if they enter a man's home, it will be like a roach motel, and they will be unable to leave. But men are increasingly kicking women out of their assets. Women can't get enough of them when sofas, other furniture, and their bodies depreciate. Women bring depreciating assets, if they bring any, whereas men bring appreciating assets in terms of potential earnings. A man's value peaks in his mid to late 30s and beyond. Even if he has a mortgage on the property, he owns an appreciating asset. The same is true for savings accounts. His stock is rising while hers is falling. She hopes that a hostile merger will save her from bankruptcy and poverty. The few women I've met with hundreds of thousands of dollars saved appeared as though they had been beaten with a stick. They understood that they could not rely on men to bail them out, so they kept for their retirement funds. However, most women believe they are pretty or attractive, so they think they will be rescued even if the likelihood is remote. When romantic technologies become available, most women will not be worth your time or effort. If she has no assets, you can typically determine this on the first or second date based on your list. Next, you must break up with her and compare her lifestyle to her income. Typically, you can discover a person's salary online and research her position or employer.